You say that you don't believe in God, and that's fine. I just wonder, why is it so important for many of you to mock those of us that do? If we're wrong, what have we lost when we die? Nothing. How does our believing in Jesus bring you any harm? You think I look stupid or gullible? That's okay. But how does that affect you? If you're wrong, your consequence is far worse. I would rather live my life believing in Jesus and serving him and find out that I was right than not believe in him and not serve him and find out I was wrong.
You're called. You can't run from it. You can't deny it. You can't pass it off. It's your call. God knew what he was doing. He knew who he was calling. And he expertly and intricately detailed every aspect of your life, your being, your persona, your psyche, your physicality, everything about you, from the texture of your hair to the color of your eyes to the way that you laugh to the fingerprint on your thumb. Everything is connected to your calling. And until you walk into the fullness of the thing that you were created for, you will find yourself frustrated.
I want to apologize to God and you guys. So recently I have been kinda lazy and I was just on TikTok all day. All the Christian TikToks I would see, I would ignore them only because they were all telling me to spread the gospel. But I was already spreading the gospel, so I decided to ignore them. Then like 2 days ago, I had a dream that the rapture was happening. I got very emotional and scared because I realized that I had been spending not a lot of time worshiping the Lord. I know this was a sign from God. I know he wanted me to continue spreading the gospel. Now, I know just spreading the gospel doesn't automatically get you into heaven. You have to really believe in it. You have to trust God enough so that he trusts you enough for him to let you in the gates of heaven. I'm making this video so you guys don't make the same mistake as me. Luckily, I've come to my senses now and I will spend more time focusing on God. Please do not say stuff like, I'm tired, I will do it later. Jesus was tired too. Jesus literally spent 6 hours on the cross, while being completely humiliated in front of lots of people. So please, if you are a Christian, spread the gospel. Do good in life. Worship God. Respect him. Don't let the Satan get in your head. But of course, if you aren't a Christian, I still hope you do well in the future. If you don't respect God, that's okay. You can scroll. Now before I end this video, let's do a prayer with the people who are still here. Romans 8:28. Take encouragement from the fact that our God is in fully control of all things. Remember yourself that we know that in all things, God works for the good who love.
Imagine life as one big test. And the only way to get to heaven is if you get 100% on this test. And then when you die and stand before God and he's judging you, he's going to hand you a report card on how you did. What do you think your report card is going to say? If I'm being honest, your report card is going to say F, failure. You're going straight to hell. And that's all of us. If it was up to us to pass this test called life, we'd all fail. And Christ knew that. Christ knew we would all fail. So you know what he did? He lived the perfect life for us. He died and suffered on the cross and rose again. And then he went to heaven and he took this perfect report card that he earned and he wrote your name at the top of it. And then he handed it to God so that if you would just put your faith in him, instead of getting the F at the end of your life, you're getting the 100%. And you didn't earn it. You don't deserve it, but you get it anyway. Because Christ loves you that much. He loves you that much. When you were still a sinner, he died for you.
Just listen.
If you're a Christian, this message could change your life. You know, in the book of Revelations, there's a list of people that won't go to heaven. And on this list, there's all types of people that you might expect beyond there. There's the sexually immoral, the thief, the liar. But there's one person on this list that I never really noticed, I never thought about, and that person is the coward. If God says the coward will not inherit the kingdom of heaven, and I started to think about my own life, and I started to realize I'm a coward. When was the last time I just went up to someone and shared the gospel with them? I don't know. I don't do that because I'm scared. I'm a coward. I'm scared of what people are going to say about me. And, you know, I think that's a lot of Christians. We say, oh, I'm unashamed of Jesus. But then when it comes time to actually share the gospel, we don't do it. We cower away because we're not brave. A brave person isn't someone who's not scared. A brave person is someone who's scared, but does it anyway. My prayer tonight is that Christ gives me the strength to do it anyway.
And God began to say, he said, I must tell you something. I said, what, Lord? He said, it's very possible to be married in different dimensions. I said, excuse me. I said, Lord, I'm not understanding. He said, you remember when I said, when a man looks at a woman and even an unclean way, he's already committed adultery with her in his heart. I said, yes, Lord. He said, did I not also say that if you lay down with a prostitute, you become one with her? I said, yes, Lord. He said, so a lot of my men, they can be married to a woman in the natural, but they lay down with a prostitute in the spirit. And what tends to happen is because their appetite is so fed in sin and so fed in fantasies that he said, son, what happened? They try to pervert the woman of God that I've given them to be like the spirit that they lay down with. And he said, but I did not make my women of that nature. And so you have a lot of men, and even men in high places, who have laid down with this spirit so long that they've got displeased with the woman I gave them. He said they're mad because what they really like in the spirit, they need flesh to communicate with the flesh. And the reason why they beat the women, they talk bad about the women, the woman of God that I've given them, is because the one they actually in love with in the spirit, they can't touch because their spirit needs a body. And so when the woman that I've given them will not convert, then they abuse them.
Okay, Batman, we'll take it from here. All right, listen up. All of you have the right to remain silent.
He is running out of patience. Today, as I was talking to God, I could feel the anger. He is running out of patience because of disobedience. How many messages, how many people need to be repeating the same thing, but you refuse to turn from your evil ways? The wages of sin is death. A lot of people won't survive these natural disasters and drought and starvation because it will affect everybody. But people of God, he said, you are protected. People of God, he said, your homes will have food and you will have water. People of God, you don't have to worry. But for the people who don't know him, he said, you are warned today. How many messages you need? How many signs do you need? God is tired. I hope you receive this message today. Get your houses in order, both spiritually and physically. You step into the store, you realize the shelves.
Say, Jesus, show me some lightning.
Jesus, show me some lightning.
Wow! Dude, that was amazing.
Yeah, that was
say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.